Google opens up early access to a dubbing tool called Aloud, which helps you dub your content in multiple languages. TikTok launches a music and distribution platform called Sound On to help independent music artists. Instagram adds enhanced tag feature that helps you tag behind the scene creators like your songwriter and photographer. All this and much more coming up in this week's edition of the Connected Church News. Welcome, I'm Nachi Lazarus, and this is a show that brings you the top 5 digital and social media news each week in just 5 minutes. Let's get started. Last week, Google opened up early access to a tool called Aloud, which is a very interesting tool for dubbing. If you have tried your hands dubbing a video content into another language, you know how difficult and complex the process is. You know, you have to get the content ready, the script done, and then sync it with the timing and so on. Now, Google, with this new experimental tool, which is part of their incubator program called Area 120, is trying to make that process easier. This could be a big, tool in the hands of churches and ministries who are trying to reach people in various people group across the world who speak different languages. So creating easier dubbed content in different languages could be a big step forward in reaching your message to different parts of the world. So do pass this information on to your video team. I will link to all the details in the show notes. Instagram has released a feature called enhanced tagging, which lets you tag a person along with their profile category. For example, if you're working with a photographer who helped you create that particular Instagram picture, then you can not only tag their name, but also put their category as a photographer. So if I help you with something, then you can say Nachi Lazarus, and below that, my category, like an artist or a songwriter or consultant or something like that. So this helps people get discovered in a better way, but also it gives the ability for you as a ministry to credit the people properly and allow them also to grow on Instagram. This could also be very useful when you're collaborating on an event, for example. You can tag the speakers and add their category to it so that it also helps your credibility. So I think it's a useful feature. Do have a look. TikTok launched a new music distribution and marketing platform called Sound On. This is a platform that is meant to help you upload your music onto the TikTok platform and also help you earn royalties if you are an independent musician or connected with music in some way. I know many ministries have music as part of their ministry and also churches. So take a look at this. It's a very interesting platform. And TikTok being TikTok, this could also help you get to people who want to discover your music. Like if you want to reach a particular people group and mostly with music, you want to reach younger audience, then TikTok is the best platform. So you put your music on TikTok and now the users will be able to discover it and use it. And when they do it, you not only earn royalty, but you also become familiar to your audience. So this could be a good tool for music ministry. Twitter launches Twitter Shops, which is now part of the profile page. So once you have Twitter Shops rolled out to you, right now they are testing it in the US with a few brands. Eventually they'll be rolling it out across the globe. Once that is available for you, you will have a call to action button called View Shop below your Twitter profile. And people can click on it and they can view up to 50 products that you have listed as part of the Twitter Shops. Twitter has been playing around with shops and products display for a while now in various formats. Now this comes to the main profile page, Twitter profile page, which could be very helpful. Meta announced last week that they are adding new features in Facebook groups to help the admins and moderators. The features include the ability for admins to streamline the way they approve member requests in a much automated manner. They also have now have tools that would help them to suspend a member. Earlier there was mute, but now they can suspend. They can also control the way the members post and the way they contribute to the community. The announcement also includes tools for the growth of the group, like QR codes. You can now use QR codes to promote the group membership. And if anyone wants to join, they just scan the QR code and join the group. So do have a look. Seems like useful features. That's all I have for you this week. week. Thank you for joining me. If you have any questions or comments related to any of the stories, do leave them in the comment section. We will make sure we get back to you. If you want to dig deeper into any of the stories, we've got all the source links and details in the description section. We also have all these details in our news page, nachilazarus.com/news. Do have a look. I'll see you next week with another set of news items. Until then, you stay connected and stay blessed. God bless you. Bye-bye.